In the book of St. John, chapter 5, verse 6, Jesus looked at a man who was impotent in his feet. He'd been this way for 38 long years. The Bible don't tell us how old the man was, but surely the man must have experienced being able to walk. But half of his lifetime, he had not walked. He had become accustomed to being impotent in his feet, and he stayed up under the porch at Bethesda. And at certain seasons, an angel would come down and trouble, stir the water, and whoever got into the water first was made whole. They were healed. This is not just some fantasy, some make-believe story. It's in the Bible in John 5, so it's a reality. This really was happening. But Jesus came and said to this man who had suffered, you know, half of his lifetime, who had not even been able to walk. He forgot what it was like to walk. But yet he was still believing to get healed. But Jesus asked him in John 5 and 6, when he saw the man lying there, and Jesus knew how long the man had been impotent in his feet, how long he had laid there, unable to walk or move or do anything, Jesus asked him a question, "Wilt thou be made whole?" Are you willing to be made whole? And the man then responded to him in verse 7, cordially. He just said, "Sir, you know, I have no man to help me, put me in the water when the angel comes down to trouble it and stir it." And then Jesus just replies to him in verses 8, "Rise, take up thy bed and walk." And by verses 9, immediately this took place. The man rises up without having to be put in the pool, without the water being stirred, without an angel present. The healer Jesus was present. And in a moment, in an instant, a man who had suffered a lifetime, who had suffered by the statement that John 5, 6 says Jesus knew he had been a long time in this case. Looked like it was going to never change. Looked like he had to live with this the rest of his life. But in a moment, Jesus said, "Will you be made whole?" And undoubtedly, the man must have believed because he received. And what he couldn't do, he's now doing. And today I want to encourage somebody's faith. You've lived so long in that case. You've lived so long with that state, that physical issue, that problem. The doctor told you were going to have to live with it the rest of your life. You're going to have to live with it because your parents before you lived with it. They had it. You inherited it. You're going to have to stay this way the rest of your days on this earth. Well, I've come to tell you by faith, in the name of Jesus, you can outlive it. You don't have to live with it the rest of your days on this earth. There is still a Christ that still not only heals, but makes whole. And friend, he's asking you a question today. Will you be made whole? Will you receive that and say, "Yes, Lord, I'm willing. I will be made whole. I will not have to live with this infirmity in my body the rest of my days just because a doctor told me I would. Or that I'm just going to have to settle for living like this the rest of my life." Let me tell you, if you think that story's amazing, think about John 9, verses 1. There was a blind man who had been blind from his birth. He's the one that Jesus spit in the mud and made mud pies and wiped them in his eyes and told him to go wash in the pool of Siloam, and when he did, he could see. This man had never saw from his mother's womb, but now he can see. Hallelujah. Friend, our God is still this kind of God. Somebody, the enemy's told you, you're going to have to live like this the rest of your life. You're just going to have to settle for this sickness. You're going to always be this way. It's going to never change. The devil's a liar and he's a father of it, John 8 and 44. I want to implant this type of faith in you. You know, I was even told something by a doctor, even today, you may just have to learn to live with this. Well, you know, the Spirit of God, and I've been living with that for a long time, but the Spirit of God, the Spirit of faith that 2 Corinthians 4:13 calls him, rose up in me, and I began to think of these stories in the Bible, like in John 5, and just where we mentioned in John 9, and how people had suffered a long time, and it looked like they could never be changed, and how people were born you know, from their birth with this condition. I was told by a doctor today, you were born like that, so you're just probably going to have to live that way. And I thought about that man that was born blind, but he saw. Jesus healed him. Hallelujah. Nothing medically could be done for these people, but Jesus healed them, made them whole. In Acts chapter 3, there was a man that laid lame at the gate beautiful. He was carried there every day. He had been lame from his mother's womb all his life. He had been lame. He had never been able to walk. But Peter, amen, said to him in verse 6, silver and gold have I none, but such as I have, I give unto you in the name of Jesus Christ. And he took him by his hand and raised him up, and he went to leaping and running through the temple of God. Friend, today I encourage you, whatever you've heard that has told you, you'll have to be this way the rest of your life. You'll just have to learn to live with it. I'm teaching you today, don't learn to live with it. Learn to believe God to change it. Yes. Until he changes it, yes. Praise him like Paul said in 2 Corinthians 12:9. He said, I will most gladly rejoice in my infirmities that the power of Christ may rest upon me. Lord, I'm going to praise you in my pain because your power will come on me as I praise you in your pain. And some of these afflictions sometimes are just for that, to produce the power of God. Jesus said about the blind man in John chapter 9, and you know, he said, this blindness is not because he sinned or his parents have sinned. It's so God might manifest his works. Sometimes God allows us to go through seasons of suffering so he can manifest his wonders and his signs. Don't learn to live with it. Yes, learn to live by faith as you're walking through it. Give God praise so his power can come on your life. But don't just settle. I'm telling somebody today, don't just settle because you've been diagnosed. Don't just settle that because your parents before you and whoever, you know, and you inherited this and you're just going to have to live like this the rest of your life. No, my friend, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, God, I pray for people who have been told you're going to have to live with this infirmity the rest of your life, that you'll never see anything different, it'll never get any better. You might as well just learn to, you know, live like this the rest of your days. God, I pray in Jesus' name for miracles, signs, and wonders. Lord, I pray you touch that part of the body, for you're the God of all flesh. Is anything too hard for you? Jeremiah 32:27. And God, we respond and we answer by faith, this is not too hard for you. And Lord God, in Jesus' name, I'm asking you to change the very temples that are yours of the Holy Ghost right now. Lord God, those parts of the flesh, God, that's even had surgeries done to them and they've been told it'll never get any better. It'll never change. Lord, I'm thanking you for signs and wonders and miracles. Come on, believe, saint of God. Believe right now, people of the Lord. Believe for miracles, signs, and wonders. Is this too hard for the Lord? No, it's not. The doctor may have been had done all they know to do. They may not can do any more than what they've done, but that don't mean that's all that can be done. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Hebrews 13:8. Malachi 3:6, he said, I'm the Lord, and I change not. So hear the word of the Lord today and be healed from the crown of your head to the soles of your feet. I command the organs in your body that do not function like they were created to be made whole in Jesus' name. God, we believe you for signs and wonders. We command parts of the body and organs that do not work to begin to work and function for the glory of God. We call things that are not as though they were, Romans 4:17. And Jesus, we believe we were healed at the heel. 2,000 years ago, by your stripes, we were healed, 1 Peter 2:24. And we receive healing because we still believe in healed. That's right. We believe healed. That's why we receive healing. Come on today. Confess it out loud. Lord, I believe I'm healed at the heel. That my healing is 2,000 years old. Come on. If God can get you to believe healed, you can receive healing. A lot of times we're trying to get healing without being persuaded that we're healed by his stripes according to what he said he did at the cross. So receive healing today as you believe in healed in Jesus' name. And I declare this word of faith, and I know for the religious and especially for the worldly, this makes no sense. It's the foolishness of God. But God said that it's through the foolishness of preaching he'll save, he'll deliver those that'll believe, 1 Corinthians 1:21. So this is a ridiculous word, but it's a miraculous word. And if you'll have faith for the miraculous, you're going to have to accept the ridiculous. God can change your life. That even means your body. God can change those things and even those diagnoses. Don't learn to live with it. Trust God. He can deliver you from it. He can change your life, even your body. Believe Him to do it right now. In Jesus' name, I agree with you. In Jesus' name.